Hello guys, so today is Saturday, which means I'm not at work and I need to spend my time doing something, and since we all need to keep this social distance, I thought what better way to keep that social distance than going for a range test on my Mörder Börd. Now this board does have a calculated range of about 100 kilometers, and this means I'm gonna reach out far and wide into the unknown universe, and therefore I need to bring emergency kits in order to survive this journey. It's gonna be a rough one. So for this trip, I'm obviously gonna need my board, the backpack, the battery, and some protection gear. I'm also gonna need air inflator, that's broken. Should I have a new one? I'm gonna need water, I'm gonna need my drone, I'm gonna need tools, and I'm gonna need protein powder, because the store is all out of food, because the hysteria is going on. And I'm gonna need a reserve board. You never know if the other one's gonna break. So now I need to package all of this stuff into the backpack. Start with the tools. Yep. Drone. Yep. Air inflator. Kinda. Protein. Somewhat. Board, that's not gonna work. I have to rethink this. So yeah, I didn't exactly fit everything in the bag, but I do have the essentials. This stuff is gonna stay here. That stuff is going with me. The battery is now at 100% for the first time ever. And for the sake of this video, I'm only gonna record small parts and then give status reports using the app, which will show the distance and everything you need to know about that. So yeah, let's go.
Armored jacket is equipped and we are ready to go on adventure. Come with me. So I'm currently cruising at 36, 37 kilometers an hour. It's consuming about 700 watts constantly now. And we have so far gone, let's see, I don't know, 4 kilometers, yeah, 4 kilometers. We're just gonna keep the cruise control on for another 100 kilometers or something. Whoopee, skippee!
Over crops and a child's face aglow before the sight. Join the harvest of 100 fields, hearty and tame, all going back to one single grain. Offer light to the coming day, inspire a child. Water the fields, surrender to the earth. Water the fields, surrender to the earth. Water the fields, surrender to the earth. They have beauty beyond the poetry, but choose a silent misery. The deeper the sea, the less remains. They'll find the pretty woods and tame flocks to herd. There's that sort of arousal of dare. Join the hearty and tame, all going back to one single grain. Offer light to the coming day, inspire a child. Water the field, surrender to the earth. Water the field, surrender to the earth.
Just to see the difference here, I'm now going for the 3 kilometers an hour on the cruise control, and it's consuming about 1,000 watts constantly. So speed does really, really matter when it comes into whether you're gonna get good range or not. I have now done 23.7 kilometers. What hour per kilometer is 25. And it tells me I have 63 kilometers left in the battery. Oh, shit, I'm going fast.
So I did find myself a store out here in the middle of nowhere. So I decided to go for a snack break because I'm a fat bastard that drinks diet soda, I guess. Data so far, we have gone 27.7 kilometers and we still have 72% battery left, or about 47 volts. Doing good. See you later.
Okay, it's time to go again. Are we there yet? Are we there yet? Ooh, a hill! Hill. I wanna go up the hill. I love hills. They are great. Jimmy is through. Shit, that's something. Go over it.
This is puncture making stone.
Look, I found moppe pojkar. Hunt them. Kom igen då. Gasa då. There yet?
Okay, so an update. We're currently at 40.8 kilometers and we have a 58% battery left. My legs are starting to get shaky from the cold weather. We gotta keep pushing.
We gotta keep pushing, pushing all the way. And if you're wondering, do I need this battery? Nope. Is it fun to ride for this long? Nope. But I'm winning. Winning!
That is one steep incline. Can I climb it? I'm too big to go inside of there. That's outside of my comfort zone. That's a steep fucker. Balls to the wall. Go, 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 go.
No!
I found my demise. I need to build something more powerful.
That place looks like fun. I did turn around a while back. Currently at about 60 kilometers. And I have 20 kilometers to home. And I'm on this beautiful country road. So country road, take me home to the day. I'm in West Virginia.
Country roads take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, Mountain Mama, take me home. Country roads. Almost heaven.
So the phone is dead. I'm not really sure where I am. I saw a sign a while back saying I had 12 kilometers left to my home village. The controller is blinking, which means I'm at cutoff voltage. And I'm on this nasty dirt road, which is demanding a lot of power from the board just to keep it rolling. I don't know, I may have 8 kilometers left. This will be interesting. Interesting indeed. Come on board, work with me here. Come on! I never actually gotten any of my DIY boards down to cut off. I don't wanna start now. Go! Go! There it is! It's over there! I'm gonna make it! Maybe. Now the board just became very, very slow. And I do not want it to reach the cutoff end. Because if it do, I will not be able to see the final stats, how far I went or how much consumption I had in average, which I do want to see once I can recharge my phone. So the board has to stay alive until then, and therefore I'm walking. I have just about 1 kilometer left. I know that from growing up here, so I will just take that off the final range.
So yeah guys, I did make it back, and now I've had a look at the numbers, which I regret because it made me depressed. I thought it was kind of weird that I had 20 kilometers to my home and the board showed me that I had 40 kilometers left in the battery. And then it just suddenly started to reach the cutoff voltage way before I thought it would ever do. So yeah, let's get into this. You know, I'm a lazy bastard, so I don't wanna use screen recorder, so I'm gonna record my screen with the camera instead. You can see that I went 77 kilometers minus the 1 kilometer that I walked. So that's a bit less than I expected. I expected something between 80 and 90 for this kind of trip where I smashed the throttle all the way on the country roads. But that's not the thing that bugs me out. What bugs me out is this. You can see the watt hour out is 2042. And the amp hours out is 47.7. According to the stats, the pack should be 55 amp hours or 2384 watt hours. So that's a significant chunk being torn off right there. And without being too nerdy about it, we're gonna investigate this a bit. So here, we got the discharge curve for the Samsung 35 ESL. And I've chosen three different types of current: 2 amps, 5 amps, and 10 amps. The highest here is the 2 amp curve. that starts off at 4.2 volts and goes down here to something like 3.3 volts. That's at 2 amps per cell. And if you think that my board draws more than that on average, let's have a look at this. You know, I'm no engineer, so I just made a very nice looking paint sheet, if you will, to show this. So my pack is a 12S 16P35E, rated at 2384 watt hours. And I kinda just made this up, but it also makes kinda sense. So this is not by any means perfect mathematics, but it's something close to the truth. So I set the average consumption to 1000 watts, divided that by the nominal voltage, and that gave me 23, so that means the average amp draw should be 23 amps. Divide that by 16, which is the parallel amount of the pack, and we get 1.44 amps draw per cell. So that's lower than the 2 amp draw that we saw on the discharge curve earlier. And according to that sheet, we're just gonna go with the 2 amp because higher marginal, I guess. So if we got a constant draw of 2 amps, we can see that the cell will give you 3.3 amp hours or 11.88 watt hours. And on this, in my pack, that would equal out to 2280 watt hours. And as you see here, that's a loss of over 200 watt hours. That's basically 7 or 8 boosted packs or something. Yeah, and even at 10 amps per cell, we can see that it should give us 3.15 amp hours or 11.34 watt hours. So in my case, I got a total consumption of 47.8 amp hours. Yada 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 gives us 2.99 amp hours or 10.76 watt hours per cell. And that's a big difference here. So Samsung, fuck you. Is that a big deal? No, not really. It's not a big deal, but it does makes me a bit sad because I spent a lot of money building this pack, and I wanted it to live up to my expectations, and I always know that the true capacity of the cells are not exactly the same as the rated ones, but in a pack of this size, the amp draw per cell is so low because you have that many cells working together to put out that amp. So I really thought I would come close to the rated capacity of this, but turns out no, I didn't. That's pretty much it. It was a good ride though. Yeah, and I just want to make this clear. If you're sitting at home right now and thinking, oh, my Evolve GTR is getting 50 kilometers out of that battery, and that's 5 times smaller, almost. Yeah, maybe you do, but your Evolve GTR is a weak-ass board as well. It's like comparing a Fiat to a Lamborghini. It's gonna consume more power. That's just the way it is. So yeah, guys, I know this was a super long video, and I don't expect anyone to watch all of it. But if you did, and if you enjoy the content and want to see more extreme electric skateboards, please consider subscribing to this channel, because that would really motivate me to keep making these videos. So yeah, that was all I had for today, so see you in the next one. Bye!